In this video, I'm going to just show how to install Neo4j graph database onto a Windows system. I'm using Windows 7. So to do that, you just have to go to this URL here, neo4j.org/download. And all the downloads are here. So obviously, because I'm on Windows, I'm going to use the choose the latest stable release and just click on the community version and download it. And then you just put it somewhere convenient. I'm just going to put it on the desktop. And it's around 38 megabytes, so it takes a little bit to download. So I'll just pause a second and come back when that... Okay, once that's downloaded, all we have to do is extract it. So I've put it on my desktop. So I can just right-click, extract the zip file. And once that's done, I can get rid of the zip file. So here's the what is downloaded, and here are all the directories. There's all the binary files here, and some documentation here. So you can put this wherever you want, really. Obviously, you need to have Java installed before you can run it. So if you haven't got Java, then just download Java JDK download, and then you can just go here and then just choose to download the JDK version and put that wherever you want. Now, there might be problems with running Neo4j, so before I try running it, just you can go to computer properties and set the environment variables for your Java installation, and it might not be a problem, but if you have any problems, just it might help. So the ones that might help are to add here in your system variables a variable called java_home. So all you do is click on new and you'll get a dialog like that, and in there put java_home and then put the location of the JDK folder. And then similarly, you can do a JRE home, and in this one, put the location of your JRE folder. And one more variable is in your path. It might be good to put in the location of your JDK/bin folder, obviously separated by a semicolon from all your other paths that you've got in your system variables. You might not have to do that, but if you've got problems, that might resolve that. So once you've got Java all sorted out, you can basically get the contents of this and put them wherever you want. I've already installed mine. I'll show you. Well, I've got mine in C tools, and then I've just put them in a Neo4j folder. So those are all the files there. And then to run it, you just go into the bin folder and just run this Neo4j bat. Now, you might have a problem on Windows trying to run this because basically there's this Windows Service Wrapper version 4.jar or number 4.jar. And in this base file here, if you open it, instead of double clicking it, open it in a text editor. And then around line 49, there's this bit here, set wrapper or whatever. Now, I've changed mine. Originally, it had like a star here. And when it did that, it came up with some error. So I changed it to the actual version, number 4, saved it. And then I think everything should be ready to run this here. So just double click it. You'll see a load of information come up here. There we go. So now it's started. And to see it in action, just navigate to localhost and then :7474. So that's the port that it works on. So there we go. And then you'll see this web administration panel, so you know everything's running. You probably have a blank database when you open it up. I've already got a few nodes and relationships on here, and you can click on the data browser, and to add a node you just click here. So you've got another node here. This is my node 6. You can add a property, say first name, and then another one, last name. Okay, so now I've got a node, and you can look at all the other nodes by if you put in another number, you'll see there's some other nodes for different node, and you can also add a relationship. So you can say node 6, and in here you can put in anything you want for your relationship. So nodes, node 1, and those are the IDs of the nodes, so I can create that relationship. So here we go, relationship 7. There's other relationships, 5, node 2, nodes, node 3. It's a handy bit here that shows you some of the queries you can put in. And I think this uses Cypher, which is a language for querying the database, and you can find out a bit more about that and put the queries in there. But I mean, just to find nodes, it's quite easy to just put the number, and for the relationship, row for relationship, and then 2, and then control enter to run the query. Otherwise, if you just put enter, it just adds another line. So that's how you add nodes and relationships to your database. And then it's quite cool because you got this switch view mode here, and you can now view your database. So let me choose a node, let's say node 2. And so now, here comes node 2, and because he knows node 1, who knows node 6, and so on and so forth. So there's your little database represented graphically. There's a nice bit here that you can style, so you can do a new style profile. I'm just going to call this new style. And instead of showing just the ID, I'm going to show the... Let's put first name, which was one of the properties I added for the node, and last name. And then just make the font size a nice big font size. A jazzed up background color. Save. And now, there we go. There's your graph database. Now, by default, the graph database is situated in the Neo4j data, and then in this graph database bit here, but you can configure it so it points to a different database. In fact, the database I was working for with there is situated in a different place. And to change it, you just go to Neo4j server properties, open that with a text editor, and then in this section here it says location of the database directory. I've changed it from the default, which is here, I've just commented out using a hash symbol. That's the original place, data graph database, and that's relative to the actual installation folder. So Neo4j is the installation folder, so data graph database. But I've just changed it and pointed it to another directory anywhere on your machine, really.